H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so now we have come to the point like we should start collections and then we will touch loops. Hope you are able to hear me properly. Now, collection framework is very easy in Python. So basically, what is collection? Collecting similar kind of objects. In Python, there is no restriction that we have to collect similar kind only. We can collect any type of objects. In Python, there is no direct support to arrays. So this is what we have. Right, so there is no separate array class which will actually provide you this. This is list, tuples, set, and dictionary. So these are the four types which we're gonna learn. Okay, so I have created this day three notes which will provide you notes. Okay, in the same project file itself. Okay, so you don't have to like grab the notes from different folders. Okay, so now Python collection basically, which is array, the first one is list. We will see the differences, what exactly they are, okay, and what are the different types and how they work. The list is a collection which is ordered and changeable. So these two words are important. First thing is it's ordered. So it's ordered by a sequence. Okay, so it's ordered by a index. So it has an index by default and it's changeable. So you can alter the values, you can alter, you can add, you can remove the items from list. In Python, lists are written in a square brackets. Now, how you declare this particular array or collection is basically like it's an identifier that what exact collection we are working with. Okay. Now, because of these properties like ordered and changeable, okay, we will get to know like when and which collection to be used. So, suppose I want to take the let's say list of employees, right, or list of items in the store for that matter. So anything which is changeable and ordered, so every item, like every employee has an employee number. Okay, so I have indexed data and I have changeable data. Employee can resign and then employee ID can be reassigned, okay, if the company policy says so. So that is called order and changeable type of collections. Okay, so let's take an example. So now how do we declare that? So for that, we will actually create our first Python module. I'll say list test. Like that. And we will actually perform a similar set of activities on all kind of collections, basically. Meaning we're going to add an element, we'll remove an element, we'll try to iterate through it, okay. So we'll check whether the element exists in the list. So we will do similar kind of operations for all the collections. So we'll get to know which one supports what. Okay. So now coming back here, and I will just write these two words here. It's ordered and changeable. It's important. Okay. So whenever you are looking at a list, you always remember it's ordered. And so what does ordered mean? So whenever I'm declaring a list, by the way, how do you declare the list? So we took an example here. It's this list. So I'll keep this example for you and I'll add some other errors. So this is, I'll say sample list. And then here I'll have a list of, let's say, items involvement, right? So I have milk carton. Okay. Then I have, what are the things I'm buying from Walmart, let's say. And then I'm buying vegetables. I'm also buying grocery items or electronics. Right? So soft drinks. Right? These are enough. So now this is sample list, like these are the items in this Walmart store. Okay, I can collect them in the list. Now, as I'm using these braces, this is wrong. So I have to use square braces. Okay. So square brackets will be a list. Remember that. If you change that, it will be a different kind of collection. So square brackets are important. And I also mentioned that in the notes. So lists are always written with the square brackets. Now how do you print print that entire list? So you can just use print and then add sample list here. Okay, and execute that, it will print that particular list. My voice is breaking and video is lagging. Everybody facing same issue? Do I have to reset? So coming back, so we are printing that particular list. Awesome. How can I get a particular item from the list? Now remember that I have indexed items here. So everything is indexed and index are from left to right. So this will be index 0. This is 1. This is 2. This is 3. So if I want to get a particular item, how can I do that? You can get it with the help of index, right? So access the item with the help of index. So print, and I want to, let's say, grab the element which is vegetables. So how do I do that? So I'll just say sample list and grab it with the help of index. This is 1. So I'll get vegetables here. So this is individual. Now can I assign something else here? Can I change this value? So remember that the list is changeable. That means I can definitely add a new value. So how can I do that? You have insert method, okay, or you have assignment. So let me do both. Right, so what happened? I had position 1, I replaced vegetable with Coca-Cola. You can use this, or there is an insert method also. So what you can do is you can use insert, so this list dot insert, and then provide what index you want to replace and what's the data. So this is also one of the ways. So we'll use this also. Let's try this. Okay, so again you are inserting orange in a sample list. The sample list dot insert, and at the position 1 we are replacing, let's replace position 0. We'll get to know that we are able to do it proper manner. So in the second list you can see that at position 0, now they see the differences. See the difference what happened here. I replaced an item, here I added an item. Okay, so replacement is done with the help of index directly. So if I say that sample list 1 Coca-Cola, the existing item on sample list is deleted and replaced by Coca-Cola. If I say insert with the already existing item, that means other indexes are basically shifted and this one 0 is added with the orange. So this is addition. Addition of new element. And this is replacement of existing element. Okay. How do we remove the atom? We use remove method. So you can use remove. So you say sample list dot remove, and then you provide which value you want to remove. Okay. You can provide index also. So remove 0, 0, right? Here it's provided value. We'll try both. Or we'll try orange first. I think for removing an index, you have to use pop method. Okay, I'll tell you that also. Don't worry. And then if I print it, orange will be removed. So in the new list again, there is no orange. Now there is a pop method which will remove the specific index, and if you don't provide an index, it will remove the last item. Okay, so we'll try that. So this is a pop method. So sample list.pop, it has an index. So if I don't provide an index, it will remove the last item, which is soft drinks. So we'll try both. At first, I'm just executing it as it is. It will remove the last element. But if I specify an index, let's say I want to remove an index 1, okay, then it will remove index 1. Coca-Cola is removed. Okay, so pop is used for removing a particular index. Similarly, there is a delete. So delete, you can actually delete an existing item. Okay, so you can delete a specific one, or you can entirely delete the list, right? So you can do that. So you have delete. Not delete, I guess. Fine. Anyway, the pop is doing the same stuff. Remove it from here. Oh, I did it wrong way. Confusion. And then provide the index. Like I want to delete an index 1. This is how it is. And then basically add print. Now, if I do that, I'm supposed to delete electronics. So let's see, it's got deleted. And you can delete entire list also. So if I say delete and then say sample list, although that's not recommended. And if I try to print it, what will happen? Now, as the list is already deleted, you don't have anything in the memory called as sample list. And you are trying to print something which doesn't exist in the memory. So you're going to get an error out of it. Yes, thank you. So you don't have anything which is called a sample list, so you will get like name error, name sample list is not defined, right? So that's not possible. So that's why I'm committing both of these statements. You're gonna try it. Nice. Now if excuse me, if you really want to clear everything, then you should use clear method instead of delete. Because delete, you're going to actually delete each and every item one by one. Okay. That will be ridiculously slow. So you can use clear method. How do you do that? So you just say sample list dot clear and it will clear all the items in the list. So sample list dot clear and clear method will actually remove everything from the list and you will get empty list. The list is empty. Last one. Okay, how do we check? Okay, so these are the basic operations, remember that. So these are the basic operations. You are adding an element into it, you are adding it to the particular position, you are removing that item. Okay, you are removing item from a particular position again, you are clearing off everything. So all those things are basic operations performed on all the collections. Okay, we're gonna try this all for all collections. Now, how do we check whether a particular item exists in the collection or not? So let's suppose I want to check whether milk is available or not, okay, in any of the collections. So how do I do that? So you can check that with the help of in functions. Okay, so here you're gonna check like if apple in the list. Okay, so you have if, then you are checking milk, and there is an in. Okay, and then you say sample list. Right, colon, and if it present, you're gonna see that okay, yes, it actually exists here. Milk is present in shopping cart. Okay, so execute that. Milk is present in the shopping cart. Okay, similarly, if I add something which is not there, if and I want to add something else like sugar. Okay, and then definitely like it won't be there because we haven't added that. So you need to have an else block, right? Else is not present. Is that? Sugar is not present. Okay, so you understand in is checking the membership of this whatever variable you are trying to search, or whatever index, or whatever value you are trying to search in the list. Okay. How do you find length? So length is by len function. So you pass length of it and check it. So I'm going to check it here itself because after clear it's anyway nothing. Print and then you say length. Okay, in that length you're gonna pass sample list. Remember, length is the same function for all the collections. Okay, so some of the functions are for all collections. Okay, so one of them is like in function is for all the collections. You can always check in. Okay, you'll always check length. Okay, so length is for loop through. So we'll see the loops later. Okay, and there is a list constructor. Okay, that's also we will see later. Okay, so when we are actually learning object oriented pattern, object oriented way, we will learn these two things. So loops and constructors, both things are pending, so we'll do it later. Fine. So this is basically a list which is an ordered, and so whenever you want to collect something, okay. So list is most commonly also known as arrays. So whenever you need array, okay, which is a reference in other programming languages, we generally use list. Okay. The next will be tuple. So this is little different than array. It is also ordered. It's a minor change. It's ordered, but you cannot change the value. It's unchangeable. Okay. What about two dimensions? So wait, hold on. Let's learn everything first. Okay. We do not have such a complication stuff. But we do add like you have array into an array. You can do that. No issues with that. Okay. Okay, so tuples are basically ordered and unchangeable. Okay, so you have index, but you cannot add, you cannot remove, okay, you cannot pop, all those things we cannot do that. You cannot delete either, right? So there are very limited operations you can do with that, right? So let's go ahead and add tuples. Test. And I'm again printing the same line. Okay, so list test. I'm closing this. This one I'm closing. And here I'm just again printing these two words because these are important. Like first thing is it's ordered. That means you have access to the index. And second thing is it's unchangeable. Even though you have access, you cannot change anything. Right. So let's declare one. So I'm going to create a tuple. And how do you do that, by the way? You declare it with the help of round brackets. Okay, so this normal process we use. Let's try to declare one. There is no other difference. So you say sample tuple, and then you're gonna use round braces. But other than that, you can actually use the same stuff.